Hello everybody, I am Dr. Keshav Valase from Mechanical Engineering Department of Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session, we'll be discussing about the mathematical treatment, that is some examples of 2D geometric transformations which we have discussed in earlier video. At the end of this session, viewers are expected to understand the basic concepts of three fundamental types of geometric transformations, that is translation, scaling and rotation, as well as mathematical treatments in dealing with these transformations, how the operations are carried out for a given data. Particularly, we are focusing on two-dimensional geometric transformations. Just to have a review of what we have discussed in earlier video, 2D geometric transformations are nothing but the operations which are carried out to modify the existing configuration of the object so as to alter its shape, size, position and orientation. Now, as a matter of example, a point in a biaxial system is taken as 1 by 2 matrix, whereas a line in biaxial system is taken as 2 by 2 matrix. Thus, any object that we take up in this computer graphics or CAD-CAM for geometric transformations, they are perceived in the form of a matrix. And these geometric transformations are carried out on the points which are used to define that object. That is a basic fundamental rule, the conceptual aspect that is carried out in geometric transformations. These are the three transformations we will talk about with mathematical examples with the given data. At this point, I expect the viewers to think of some image, some object, like maybe a line or a triangle. And for this object, think of how these geometric transformations will have the effect on that object. Let us talk firstly the example for translation. As we have already discussed, in this translation as a geometric transformation, we are repositioning the given object. The example given here is to translate a line passing through two points. These are two points given are 1, 1 and 2, 4. A line is passing through these two points and we are supposed to translate this line by a distance of 2 units along x direction and 3 units along y direction. Now, we already discussed this relationship in earlier video for the point. The same we will now apply it for a line wherein 2 by 2 matrix we need for the representation of a line. A line passes through two points, hence conveniently a line is represented as a 2 by 2 matrix. So, if L is the original line given, L dash is a translated line and T is the translation matrix, then we have L dash, that is a translated line, is equal to L given or original line plus translation matrix. Remember, in translation we add the matrices. Thus, with the given data, L, the line, can be represented as this 2 by 2 matrix of two points. Point 1 will be put up as 1, 1 here in first row and second point will be put up in second row, 2, 4. And next to this is a translation matrix T, which is represented as 2, 3 and 2, 3. This 2 is the translation distance along x direction and this 3 is the translation distance along y direction. As we are adding the matrices here, these translation distances along x and y, we are supposed to repeat for both the rows. So this is the way we represent translation matrix for a line which is represented as a 2 by 2 matrix. And thus we are supposed to find out what is L dash, that is new translated line. Now with the relation we have, L dash is equal to L plus T. This L is put up as a given line in 2 by 2 matrix form. This T as a translation matrix is put up again as 2 by 2 form. Adding these two matrices, we get L dash, that is translated line. We get these two points in the form of 2 by 2 matrix. If you see this figure here, here this is the original line passing through two points, 1, 1 and 2, 4, whereas this line is the translated line which is passing through 3, 4 and 4, 7. So these are the points 3, 4 and 4, 7 we have calculated. So this is the original line, this is the translated line. Coming to second type, scaling, wherein we either enlarge the object or reduce the object. Now here again the same example is given, same data is given, wherein a line is passing through two points, 1, 1 and 2, 4, and we are expected to use a scaling factor of 2 along both the axes, that is along x and y. Scaling factor along both the axes is given to be same, that is 2. Formula here to be used is L dash is equal to L into S, wherein L is the original line, L dash is the line after scaling, and S is the scaling matrix. This L line, as usual, we have represented as 2 by 2 matrix of 1, 1 and 2, 4, these two points. S, the scaling matrix, needs to be represented as 2, 0 and 0, 2. In first row, this 2 represents the scaling factor along x direction. As we are multiplying it here, for the sake of algorithm, this coordinate, this point in the matrix needs to be 0. Whereas here, this 2 is the scaling factor along y-axis. So with this representation for the given data, we have to find out new line after scaling. Looking to the formula again, we have L dash is equal to L into S. We are multiplying here. In translation, we add the matrices, but in scaling, we multiply the matrices. So this L dash is equal to, this L is the given line in the form of 2 by 2 matrix into S. S is the scaling factor, Tx and Ty, or these are scaling factors along x and y directions. After multiplication, we get these coordinates 2, 2, 4, 8. Coming back to this representation here, this is the original line given, and this one is the scaled line after scaling. The scaling factor is given 2. So you can compare here against this line is almost doubled. So this is 0.22, as we have got it here 22, and this point is 48, which is here 4 and 8. The point to be noted here is after scaling this original line to this position, this point is shifted to this point. This point doesn't remain here. If you need this line to be doubled with this point fixed at this location, you are required to add up one more geometric transformation of translating this line from new line from this point back to this point. That we are not talking here, that is called as concatenation, which we are not talking here. Coming to third one, rotation. Here, a given object we rotate about origin through an angle of theta, wherein here plus theta, as we have discussed earlier, rotation is along clockwise direction, counterclockwise direction, whereas minus theta, it is clockwise. Same example is given for the point 1124, the line passing through two points 1124, but the angle given is plus 30, theta is plus 30. So plus 30 means we have to rotate through counterclockwise direction. L dash, again as usual, line after rotation, L is the original line, R is the rotation matrix. So this is given line, and R, the rotation matrix, is in terms of cos theta sine theta, given here as discussed in earlier video. With the formula we know, this L dash we get with the multiplication of L into R. So this is L, this is rotation matrix R, and the product of these two comes up as it's given here. So this point 0.366 and 1.366, this point comes up here after rotation, and second point comes up at this position. This is the original line, this is the rotated line. These are the two books we have referred, Grover and Ibrahim Zaid. Thank you.